All right, what's up, Team Scribe? It's another day, it's another dollar. It's your girl Scribe Cash here, aka Sports Bra. Sports Bra Scribe, aka Fresh Face Scribe. We're here, we're live in the IE, in my bedroom to be exact. And I need you to go ahead and like and click that subscribe button because we are here doing another reaction. I told you we're gonna have these every single day. You're gonna see my face every single day, so you might as well just get used to it. Like, ultimately, just get used to it. Okay. I can say okay like 30 different ways, but that's besides the point. So today we're gonna be reacting to Phora On My Way. And like, if you're like me, like a lot of people are like me, then you may have been late to this whole Phora thing. Like, this whole Phora euphoria thing. Because it is a thing. It really is a thing. And the crazy part about it is, like, I really should have been on this because he's from California. I think it's, like, Santa Ana, to be exact. And I was, like, hella late. Like, hella late. Like, I didn't catch on to him until I heard that To the Moon song. Send me to the moon. Like, that mess was cold. Like, that was, as soon as I heard that, I was like, I just want to be in love. Like, that thing was cold. And I was like, okay, I gotta bump all his music. And the craziest part about him is just like, bro, he's depressing. Like, that's not to say like his music is not motivational. That's not what I'm saying. And that's no diss to him whatsoever. Because like I said, I am a fan of Euphora. I really am. But it's kind of depressing. Like, if you really sit there and think about it, like, he's talking about like getting like shot and like being on like drugs and like paranoid and like depressed. And he's albino, which I think is so dope. I grew up around an albino kid, and he was, like, super duper dope. And I just think that's dope. Like, bro, you're black. Like, that's hella cool. And he's got, like, curly hair. And he is kind of cute. Like, I'm gonna be honest. Like, from a female's perspective, he really is kind of cute. Like, I really do. Like, it's something to him. Like, it's something to him. It's not, he's not like a, you know how there's, like, a Chris Brown fine? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's not like a Chris Brown, like, dang, you gonna turn your head and all that. But, like, he's, like, he's the guy who was in the friend zone, but, like, after he was in the friend zone, you really started talking to hang out with him, like, you really, like, mess with him, like, high key, like, you do, and so that's why he's cute to me. But enough of that. Back to his music. What I think that's dope about him is the fact that it's true. Like, it's a real story. And hell, it may be the same story over and over again, but it doesn't get old. I don't know why. Like, he's got, like, this Sade type of, like, just so subtle, like, so sultry to the point where he's like, is he singing or is he rapping? Is he rapping or is he singing? I don't know. I don't really know, but I like it. I like it a lot. And so, like, and it's so soft and smooth. It's like, it's definitely kind of like smoker's music, but at the same time, it's not, because it's just like, I don't know, is it cruising music? It's like, maybe that's why he has so many music videos where he's just like in a car, like constantly, because like his music is the type of songs that I love to play like in the car. And it's just like, I don't know, is it, it's almost R&B, it's almost like alternative hip-hop, like if I could describe what it is. But the other thing, like, I love people who are, like, true entrepreneurs. And that's what he is to me, is he is a true entrepreneur. In the sense, and, like, if you saw my reaction to Futuristics Up, like, he's an entrepreneur because he started his own clothing line called Yours Truly, and just people fell in love with it. And I'm not even gonna lie, like, I did too. Like, I just think that when you could turn something out of nothing, like, we're in America, we love a good underdog. Like, the underdog wins in our heads, at least, every single time. And so, when I can see somebody to go from, like, having such tragedy to, like, being triumphant, then I'm rooting for you. So, without further ado, we are going to go ahead and just get right into this video, and let's go. Okay, so we got some pretty views and the road. Present day, he's cruising.
Yeah, I'm on my way, yo.
See, this is what I said, like, this whole car thing, like, he's got, like, a whole car vibe all the time. And so, oh, okay, so that's that chick. But, okay, so if you're a fan of Phora, then you know that he was dating this chick, well, not this chick, but his videographer, Desi, right? And I'm pretty sure that's her, and I hope it is her, so I'm not talking about the wrong person. But, like, they broke up for a while, so I wonder, like, how they got back together, or if they got back together, or if she's just in the video. Like, that's crazy, though, like, lately I've been really trying to hold on, but I get in my feelings with the slow songs. That was 6 years ago. Still stuck in my ways, wish it used to be like back in the day. That's like not that long. And she was shooting the videos, you get it? So like, this is like whole concept of like their relationship and everything. Like, he's literally a millionaire now, like, that's so dope. Just rapping in his room. It's just so smooth. It really is. It's so simple. It's so calming. Like, it's almost like meditation music. Like, and he doesn't really do a lot. He really doesn't. He's just like, the music just does the work for him. And that says a lot about his, like, his beat selection and instrumentation, though. Like, the fact that he doesn't really have to do anything. Wow. And maybe because she disappeared, that means they're not together. Or maybe he misses her. I'm like, I don't know. I'm just like, oh, this is cool. A little throwback. Man. Like, when you talk about, like, some humble beginnings, though, and it's like, we see this time and time again, and this is really the true definition of what, like, an American dream is. The American dream is that you could start off from nothing, like, nothing at all, and you could work your way to something successful. Like, this is this concept that we really truly believe in, and, like, I hate to get, like, too tapped into it, but if we really sit here and we want to talk about this, like, the American dream is, like, it's something we all believe in, but at the same time, is it as easily accessible to every single person? No, it isn't. Like, ways and means. Like, we have to talk about, like, of course, you can get a job. You could start off from nothing. And America's a lot better than a lot of other countries out there. Don't get me wrong. But I just find it so interesting that we all believe in this dream, but yet at the same time, we don't want everybody to have access to it. Like, because if we all believed in that dream, then there would be certain systems in our society that would be set up that way. Like, and I'm going to tap into it, but this is part of us doing reactions, like, really having this conversation, like, i.e., like, college. We talk about go to college and get a good job, right? That's, like, supposed to be the concept and have an education. But it's, like, our education system now, it's not set up for everybody. In order for you to go to college, that means you have to have the grades to go to college. You have to have a certain SAT score. Right? But, like, people lose that from way beyond. It starts in, like, elementary school, then it goes to middle school, and then it goes to high school. So what if you start off at a boo-boo elementary school or a boo-boo kindergarten? You're already behind. Then you get to elementary school, and then you're behind. And then you get to middle school, and then you're behind. And then you're high school, you're playing catch-up, or it's too late, and then you try to get SAT prep. How are you going to get SAT prep if you can't afford SAT prep? Then if you get a boo-boo SAT score, you don't get to the right college. And then if you're not at the right college, then you're not making the right connections, unless you're not making the right job. But we're just supposed to have this American dream where it's accessible to everybody. It's not accessible to everybody. And yes, I do still believe that if you really do dedicate yourself to something, you work hard at doing something, you're still gonna get that result of winning in the end of some sort. But this concept, it's like, it's not all the way there. And I'm not saying don't believe in your dreams. For sure do that. But I am just saying, like, maybe we should just be, like, look a little bit more critical. But anyway, none of that had to do, what had to do with it, but it didn't really have to do with it. You know how I am. I ramble. I'm saying, ultimately, that was a cool video. Phora is dope. I'm going to keep doing reactions to his stuff because I like him. And I'll see you tomorrow.